you can hear our next live guest here on In Tune at the Royal Albert Hall at the Proms, because Seong-Jin Cho plays Prokofiev's second piano concerto with the BBC Symphony Orchestra. No Prokofiev for us now, but Mozart, the improvisatory brilliance of the D minor Fantasia. Seong-Jin Cho live in the In Tune studio.
Thank you.
music made on the wing, live, of course, in the In Tune studio. Seong-Jin Cho, live on In Tune, the first of his three performances for us on the show today with Mozart's Fantasia in D minor, K397. Well, all that Trainspotting K numbers doesn't do justice to what we've just heard, Seong-Jin. This was new. It felt that I haven't heard the piece like that before. How do you approach music like Mozart's, which you've known for so long, to make it feel fresh every time you play it for us?
Yeah, but the Mozart's music has so much layers, and this fantasy has like feeling of improvisation. And I just try to play like improvisation, as free as possible, and as much free as possible, and, you know, of course, it's not a Chopin. The music itself is very lyrical and sometimes melancholic, but shouldn't be like a romantic music. Yeah.
It couldn't be more different from the Prokofiev Second Piano Concerto, which you've just come from a rehearsal with the BBC Symphony Orchestra. This is another world, you know. You've just been playing Prokofiev, that huge virtuosity, and now you play Mozart for us. You know, what's your approach to Prokofiev then? That huge piece you'll play tomorrow night.
Well, I think Prokofiev is like Mozart of 20th century.
Mozart of the 20th century.
Yeah. And especially the second concerto, which is one of my favorite concertos, has such a deep emotion and very dramatic, because Prokofiev composed this piece just right after one of his friends committed suicide. And he's like, great idea of writing this kind of monster is so great and special.
Is it monstrously difficult for you?
Of course.
But I wonder what's harder, because you've said, okay, so you win the Chopin competition in 2015, you have to play a lot of notes for that competition, but you said actually it's often the music that seems simpler that takes you longer to find, or that becomes more difficult the more you play it. You've said that about Mozart,
yeah.
That actually this music, where there are fewer notes, in a way is harder.
Yeah,
is
that's
that really
true, I think. Yeah. When I, you know, like Prokofiev's Second Concerto, I feel it's getting better and better, like, after I practice. But
sure.
Like Mozart, it's getting worse and worse. I don't know why. It's hard to explain.
Where does that come from in you? I mean, your relationship with, you know, many pianists think, well, the more virtuosic it is, it's like a red rag to a bull. You know, you just the more notes, the faster, the better. But you're saying, really, the opposite there.
Personally, I think there's no easy music. There's no music which is easy to play. But it's different kind of like demand, and Prokofiev certainly the technically is so difficult, especially the cadence of the first movement, and also the crazy like jump of the last movement. It's almost impossible to play all the right notes, but I just try to like play as many notes as possible. But Mozart has different difficulties. Like, of course, there's some pieces which has a lot of critical passages, like sonatas or concerto. But this kind of fantasy, obviously, technically, is much easier than Prokofiev's Second Concerto. But musically, I cannot say it's easier than Prokofiev.
Where do you learn this? Some of your mentors, the pianists who you love and admire the most, Radu Lupu, Christian Zimmermann, Alfred Brendel, have they helped you, or is this a journey you have to do on your own somehow?
But I think everybody has different problem. And I asked Radu that which sonata, Schubert sonata, is the most difficult for you. And he said the C minor sonata.
Okay, the second last one.
Yeah, the big one. But for me, it's B flat major, the last sonata. For me, is the most difficult one. So, I think everybody has a different problem. Yeah.
You've said in an interview that the thing you like most in the world is silence.
Oh, yeah. How did you know that?
Oh, well, I mean, look, I just read these. But I mean, is that, again, that might seem counterintuitive to somebody who will be making a lot of noise in the Royal Albert Hall tomorrow. What's the relationship between, you know, silence and your experience of it and the music you make?
Well, I like silence because it makes me calm and I can, like, it's like a meditation. And I like here because it's very silent in the studio. I've never seen this kind of silence for a while.
It is acoustically dead, but of course the magic of our recording engineers give the reverberation as if you are in a beautiful concert hall to everyone listening at home. Seong-Jin, what are we going to hear now? More Mozart. We have Brahms coming up later in the program, but more Mozart. Now, this is B-flat major sonata?
Yeah, this piece was written when Mozart was 18 years old. And, you know, I feel sometimes ashamed.
Like, why?
What did I do when I was 18? Like, Mozart wrote this fantastic, genius piece when he was 18. And
yeah, well, you were winning competitions in Moscow, and there was... I know you're not comparing yourself to Wolfgang, but, you know, you're not doing badly, Seong-Jin. let's hear then this... thank you very much for being with us. We've got the Rondeau, the finale from music by the teenage Mozart, played by pianist in their mid-20s, Seong-Jin Cho. The Rondeau from Mozart's Sonata in B-flat major K-281 live on In Tune. That's just an improvisatory kaleidoscope, that performance. Thank you, Seong-Jin Cho, live in the Intune studio. Oh, magic. Well, what are we doing? Yes, sorry. This is, you know, the intensity of that, it's what he finds in the timing. It's, you're a comedian as well, Seong-Jin. I feel like there's a lot of... the comic timing you do brilliantly in that. So yeah, are you interested in stand-up?
Especially this piece is so humorous. You know?
It is. Thank you. We've got more Brahms from you, amazingly, to come on In Tune today before 7 o'clock. But on Monday on In Tune, you can hear the bass Brindley Sherritt. He'll be singing Sarastro in Mozart's The Magic Flute in Glyndebourne's annual visit to the Proms. But here he is in Handel, healthy, hearty, ruddier than the cherry. Well, Brahms is on his mind and on the air. The A major intermezzo from Opus 118.
Thank you.
Seong-Jin Cho live in the Intune studio. Oh, that performance just, you know, Seong-Jin, it just gets to the thing about that music, that its sighs are simultaneously anguished and radiant. I don't know how you did that, but thank you very, very much indeed. And thank you for all your playing on In Tune today. Brahms' A major Intermezzo, Opus 118. And you can hear Seong-Jin tomorrow at the Proms, live here on BBC Radio 3, in Prokofiev's second piano concerto with the BBC Symphony Orchestra and Christian Macellaro. Thank you again, Seong-Jin.
Thank you.